Sorry. So now we'll move into a hair tutorial. Get your raffle tickets ready because there will be a raffle during this tutorial as well. This is going to be Madison Zimmers from Feather and Fringe Salon in La Mesa. We're just going to mic her up 1 second.
Yo. Hi guys!
That was loud.
How are you guys doing this morning? Yeah? Okay, so I am Madison. I am Jackie's hairstylist when she was getting her hair done. So I was doing the orange hair that you guys probably have seen on her. And right now we're kind of going through a transition of growing out her hair and also not using heat on her hair. So for myself, I don't always put heat on my hair. I actually do my hair like literally once a week, and I'll just curl my hair like this once a week and just rock it until the wheels fall off, basically. So then after that, I like to incorporate like some awesome braids or ponytails. So I know it gets hard to style your hair every day and find something that works for work, school, whatever you guys do. If you guys stay home and you're a mom, I feel like just putting 5 minutes into your hair really like transforms your entire look. So I was thinking I was going to show you guys a couple of things. My go-to little hairstyle right now is pigtails. I just love pigtails right now. So I told Jackie that I would show you guys how I do my own pigtails. And then after that, I'm going to pull some of you guys up here and do some styling on you guys. So, yeah. Okay, so for my hairstyle, I obviously have long hair and I have extensions, but I make it super duper quick and easy. Like, just doing a little braid makes everything, makes it look like you put 10 minutes into your hair. So I have some elastics. I have clear and black. The clear ones might not hold all of my hair since I have so much of it now. So typically I would just section my hair in the back, and I'm kind of doing this without a mirror. I might not need this right now. So I just kind of section my hair, nothing neat. You might be able to see my extensions. I wear a hat with this look all the time. So pull some hair out in the front if you guys have some face framing pieces. Thanks for following along, guys. You're doing the braids too? Okay, so I just keep it low. An elastic. Just like that. And then I'll take like a little baby piece of hair and I'll wrap it around the elastic. And I'll bobby pin it. Like that, and then I'll section into three and I'll do a very loose braid. This literally takes me like 5 minutes to do to get ready, and it completes the entire look. So I'll do a loose braid. Elastic it off again. And then I love distressing my braids. So what that means is I just loosely braided it. I'll take my index finger and my thumb, and I'll just lightly pull on the edges and make the braid chunkier, messier. I want it to look kind of like tousled and bohemian looking. Really easy to do. Okay. And then sometimes I just leave the ponytail like this if it's clear, because I have blonde hair. If not, I'll just wrap it again. Super easy. In this. Do you guys like to braid your hair? Yeah? I used to have short hair and then I got extensions and now all I do is just braid my long hair. Your guys' makeup looks great. You guys learned some new things with Jackie? He's the bomb. Okay. Section into three. Is everyone like understanding this? Okay. Section into three. Lightly. French braid. Distress it again. Do you guys distress your braids? Do you guys know how to? I like it to look messy, so I'm not worried if it looks like too messy. I don't normally have acrylics, and now I have acrylics, and I don't know how to work my fingers now, all of a sudden. Okay. And then a little hairspray. Mm. messed it up a little bit, so pardon that. And yeah, that's how I do this look. I literally wear this every week. Thank you. And then I throw a hat over. I like to accessorize a lot. Just make sure you have fun with your hair. Hair is so pretty. And this took me, like, what, 5 minutes? Do this for work all the time, and that's it. Okay. Thanks. Okay, so I was thinking, I'll have a couple of you guys. Does anyone want to volunteer? Yeah? I just feel so bad because it's like everyone wants to volunteer. Okay, then you come up. Okay, come on up. And you have long hair. I love it. If I could do everyone's hair today, I would. Hi. What's your name? Liz. I'm Madison. Nice to meet you. Thank you for being my model. Have a seat. Okay, so Jackie and I discussed the other day that we just want this to be effortless. I don't want to confuse you guys by curling hair or I just want you guys to know that like you can achieve anything with just natural hair, not needing to add heat. You can dress up any style. So I think for you, I just do this with like no rhyme or reason typically. So I'm going to give her a cute little low ponytail that she could wear to work. And I'll show you guys. I just sectioned off a portion in the front around the ears on both sides. Yeah. Question. My extensions? Are you asking what extensions I have? I have beaded wefts, so they're, it's hard to describe. It's like a row, it's like a, I have three halos in my hair basically, all beads around, and then hair sewn to each bead. I don't know them as microlinks, I know them as habit hand tied, if that name sounds familiar. Okay, so maybe the microlinks might be like the individual beaded hair. That's what I know them as. But yeah, then I also do tapes. I do the habit hand ties at my salon. I love extensions. My extensions, I'm a very bad example because I get my hair done like literally twice a year and I'm a hairstylist. It's so bad. But I go 13 weeks. Every 13 weeks, I get my hair done. I get my extensions moved up, but I take really good care of my hair. So, yeah, I do everything with it. I even go swimming in the ocean, and they look like crap afterwards, but I try and do everything. I don't let extensions stop me from what I want to do. So I did this low little ponytail. If you can turn your head this way a little bit, perfect. So I don't know, you guys can probably see this. I literally just pinch the hair. I don't want it to look like it's too tight. I want it to look like she has volume. And then, do this side. I'm gonna pull this hair loosely. And I'm going to twist it. And then I'm going to distress it by pinching with my index finger and my thumb. Okay. The messier it looks, the better. And then I'm going to twist this around the ponytail. And then just the little hair left, I'm just gonna bobby pin it to the base of her neck. Pull it tight, stress it a little bit more. If any hair falls out, I just take a bobby pin and tuck it. And then, can I have you look the other way now? Perfect. And then I'm going to loosely pull, twist, and make sure when, if you're doing this to yourself or if you're doing this on a friend, make sure you're pulling the hair in the direction that you want to lay it down. So I don't want to be twisting it right here and making it tight right here, and then when I pull it back, it's not loose enough for it to go with the ponytail. So I always pull the hair where I want it to lay and twist from there. But this is a cute little ponytail that you can wear to work or school, and I guarantee you're going to get compliments on it, and it's not even going to take you 5 minutes to do at home. The only reason why I learned how to do hair is because I was in seventh grade and one day wanted to learn how to braid, and I just went on YouTube, and I learned how to braid all on there. And so it's funny that Jackie does YouTube, and I always say, like, YouTube totally contributed to my career because now I do hair. I absolutely love it, and I learned how to style hair off of YouTube, basically. So I'm just going to loosely just stress it, pin this little guy to the base of the neck. Pull the ponytail tighter, and then we can polish up any hairs that we want. The tuck. And then I always pull hair around my face. Add a couple more bobby pins just to secure it. That is the finished look. Can I have you stand up and show our people what it looks like? So I just sectioned off the front right by the ears, pulled everything else back and put it in a low ponytail, twisted the front pieces back and wrapped them around the ponytail and bobby pinned. Does that make sense? 5 minutes. Thank you so much. You look great. You're welcome. Okay. Anybody else? I know you want to. Okay, can I do something with your hair? So I went accessory shopping, and I picked these up at H&M. And one of the girls, Jackie's friend Heidi, she was getting her hair done by me earlier this week, and we were like Pinteresting ideas about what I wanted to do and show you guys. And I think this cost, you can have a seat, babe. This costed $2.99. And I'm not going to use all of them, but I want to show you guys kind of a red carpet look. So for this, I would probably wear this if I was going out to dinner. I always like to do something with my hair because one, I'm a hairstylist. People are going to ask me, like, oh, that looks so cute. How'd you do that? Yada, yada, yada. And that's how I get business, is I hand them my business card and tell people that I do hair. So when I go out, what's your name, by the way? Jennifer. This is Jennifer, guys. So I love Jennifer's hair. Obviously, it's a medium length, a little bit shorter, but you can still do anything with this kind of hair. So as for like the Hollywood look of it, I am going to part her a little bit further over. Give her more volume on one side than the other. And what you can do is just back comb it a little bit. Smooth it out. And then for this side, everyone is going to see this and they're going to ask her, like, oh. Or they're going to tell her, oh, that's so cute. I love that look. I'm going to have you look that way just a little bit. I'm going to loosely pull the hair back over the ear. It'd be great if you wore, like, some cute earrings with this look. But since these bobby pins are a little bit more, they're metallic, so they're noticeable. You purposely put these really cute rose gold bobby pins right here. And I'm just going to... no rhyme or reason. Just lay these bobby pins. You can make like a little crisscross. Just like that, she threw, how many bobby pins is this? Eight bobby pins, and now she can go out to dinner, go out to the bar, do whatever she wants to do, and people are going to ask her, oh my goodness, that's so cute, I would have never thought to do that. And this is what people are wearing on the red carpet nowadays. All I did is I just gave her a deeper parted side part and pulled the other side back. Bobby pinned it, no rhyme or reason, and I just created a little design. Can I have you look this way? Sorry, over to the left, sorry. Just like that. She has a cute little look. Hey, thank you so much, Jennifer. Okie dokie. And then I'll show you guys one last little braid. Anyone wanna? Okay, you with the white shirt. Sorry, I love you guys all. I wish I could do all your guys' hair today. I heard you talking, saying that you wanted to come up. Perfect. Oh, here. I'm going to put you probably this way. Okay. What's your name?
Jennifer.
Oh, Jennifer. Perfect. Okay, so for this part... long, beautiful hair. I'm going to show you guys something really, really simple. I used to do this hairstyle when I was younger, and now it's back and more bohemian and effortless. Okay. So I'm just going to take a section right here. Pretty good chunk of hair. I'm going to elastic, And then I'm going to part the hair down the middle, go underneath this elastic right here, stick my finger through the middle, and grab the ponytail through. See what that creates? And then I'm gonna take my fingers and distress it. Pull it tight. And then I'm gonna take another section. Elastic, flip it under or over the elastic, pull it tight and distress it. Take another section. Do you guys see what I'm doing now? Thank you. These acrylics are playing games with me. Okay, just like that, pull it tight, distress it. And then now, she has enough hair to wear towards the front, and I'm just gonna grab all of this right here, separate into three, and then I'm just gonna French braid downward. Elastic this off. Pull the sides of the braids with my fingers. Stress it a little bit. And all these styles were no heat. No nada. You can use hairspray. Sometimes I don't even use hairspray with my hair. I don't always like the feeling of it. So see that braid? And then scrunchies are my favorite thing ever. So I'm just gonna accessorize and throw on a little scrunchie. Okay. How cute. I wish you could see the back. Oh, yeah, you can. Perfect. All right, you guys, that is it for my tutorials. Do you guys have any questions? Oh. Is the mic on?
All right.
You tried. Oh.
All right. Can you hear me?
No.
Okay.
Hello? We're gonna do a raffle.
All right. So,
okay. Ooh, fun.
Working. Yes. Okay. Oh. Thank you. All right.
All right. So, I'm picking a ticket.
We're gonna do the headband.
Headband. Oh. Okay. I read the number. I was like, no one won this. Okay. 342741. Yay!
Hey. Okay, looks like we have some shampoo. Mm. Mushroom and bamboo color perfect shampoo.
342723. Ending 2-3.
Here it is.
You?
Woo! My sister.
Awesome.
Okay, and the next one's going to be a mushroom bamboo color perfect primer.
Interesting. Okay. 342480. 342480. Woo! Yay!
Thank you, Madison.
Thank you.
All right, so we're going to go into a 15-minute break. You guys can stick around here, finish your makeup, or go into the lobby. We have cookies, lemonade, coffee. Oh, I'm sorry, water, coffee, and iced tea. There's also restrooms, and there will also be a 5-minute countdown. All right?
And if you guys have any questions, feel free to come up and chat with me.